Hello, and welcome to this pre-recorded event for the June 2015 examination for Unit B2 GCSE Additional Science, Biology. To help you get the most out of this feedback, you may want to have the following documents handy, as we will refer to them during the session. Here are the aims and objectives of today's session. You will receive feedback on national performance of candidates in Unit 2 of the June 2015 examination series. Consider the variation of candidates' performance on different questions and possible reasons why. Look at the examiner's report. Address common issues. The next three slides will look at question 6B, part 2, of the higher tier paper. This is a straightforward explanation of how the beagle Tegon can be cloned. This candidate scores the marks for the points made about the stages involved in cloning a mammal. All stages are included in the correct order. This answer was confused and incorrect. Although the candidate had an idea about how organisms are cloned, they failed to be specific in the first instance about the cell which was to be cloned, and then proceeded to make comments more appropriate for genetic engineering rather than cloning. Thus, the candidate did not score any marks. In this question, successful candidates understood the concept of cloning, were able to make links between the stages involved in cloning, were able to link this back to the cloning of the beagle Tegon. The next three slides concern question 1, part A1, which was a calculation based on readings from the graphs and illustrates the different ways in which this question can be tackled. This candidate scores both marks here for the correct response, but one mark could have been awarded for the correct working, even if the answer was calculated incorrectly. This candidate also calculated the percentage correctly, but used a different method, which is equally acceptable. This answer shows that the candidate has used incorrect readings from the graph and seems to have counted up totals rather than readings from the graph. The marks for calculation cannot be awarded here, as the readings are not misinterpretations from the graph. In this question, successful candidates were able to read accurately from the appropriate graph where there were two graphs to choose from. Correctly calculate a percentage value. Include their working to maximize potential marks, even if they incorrectly calculated the answer. Look at this example of an answer to question 3C, part 3, on the foundation tier paper. Using the mark scheme, decide what mark you think should be awarded and why. This is a point at which you can pause the video to look at the whole question on page 7 of the question paper and the mark scheme, and decide on the mark and why. This was a very good response, and many candidates produced answers of this quality. Out of the four marking points available, this candidate's answer addressed three of them, and so scores three of the four marks for the question. Successful candidates, understood that translation occurs in the cytoplasm, at the ribosome. tRNA brings amino acids to the ribosome. tRNA joins to the ribosome to form a polypeptide chain. On this question, more successful candidates were able to relate any inherited disease to the genetic disease, were able to identify valid advantages and disadvantages, such as preservation of endangered species. On this question, less successful candidates were not able to relate any inherited disease to the genetic disease, were unable to identify valid advantages and disadvantages. Candidates who did less well were not able to explain the common advantages and disadvantages of cloning, such as early death, very few survive to adulthood, or retaining genetically desirable characteristics. The next two slides are about 6B on the Foundation question paper, the 6-mark question. Common issues here are the candidate not being able to describe the specific relationship between enzyme and substrate, make correct reference to the active site, relate structure of the enzyme to their function. In this case, the candidate has used the classic style diagrams to explain the structure-function relationship of the enzyme. They have also made reference to optimum conditions. They have also shown in diagrammatic form the denaturation of the enzymes. Unfortunately, they fail to make reference to the active site on the enzyme. Unsuccessful candidates were unable to relate the structure of the enzyme to its function, were confused where the active site was or failed to mention the active site, gave no reference to specificity or optimum temperature or pH. Successful candidates could either draw labeled diagrams to illustrate the structure and function of enzymes, or refer correctly to enzymes' active site, specificity, and optimum conditions. The next three slides are about question 4A, which is a 3-mark question on the higher tier paper. You may want to pause and look at the question and the associated mark scheme before embarking on this activity. Marks were awarded here for a comparison using the data in the graph. This candidate scored all available marks, so was awarded 3 marks, as they managed to give a good comparison of the data and picked out the relevant areas of the graph to discuss. Candidates lost marks here because they were unable to read the question carefully, giving responses that were related to the topic being tested, but not answering the question as set. Had difficulty in including the comparative. Both running and walking are needed for the mark. Had difficulty in analyzing, interpreting, and evaluating data. Were not thinking through answers before writing. Were not looking to the mark allocation when answering the question. Statistics information. Explanation of GCE and GCSE reform. Thank you.